Well, I was in the park one day with my hula hoop, and I saw Bill going past on his penny farthing, and we just got talking. I showed him my scrapbook of doodles, and he said, "Well, I doodle too."
I doodle too.
There are often things that you can't express because it's about communication, but in a different way. So we're allowed to maybe express ourselves even further than what you could do just with words. I like the doodle zebra because the zebra has a really great way of expressing itself without doing anything.
You're a genius.
It's a zebra. But yet, subtly, it isn't a zebra. It's an individual interpretation of what a zebra could be.
If you look, there's something quite concerned about the zebra.
What's wrong?
It has nothing to eat.
Hungry zebra.
You're going to places I'm not sure I'm comfortable. Have you not seen the hungry zebra? That tells you everything you need to know. She's in a higher place. But the beauty of it is, it doesn't take away the fun. It doesn't take away the enjoyment. There's no pressure to go to these places. She's my guide.
So if you look up there, you're going to see the mad professor with his big moustache. He has a big nose and he has the ball ring in his nose as well. He has a really big head and he has a small body.
Right.
Then it continues to the happy cloud. We never really associate happiness with clouds. And then it takes you into the sea where there's the mermaid. And usually the mermaid is evil. Okay, even though she's beautiful, she's always seen as evil. Okay, so she has an evil face, she has evil eyebrows, but actually she's really happy, okay? And then there's a boat that comes towards her, and it's not, there's no men in that boat. They are actually the owl and the pussycat with their sandwiches, and they're really happy.
Interestingly enough, I started right next to your owl and pussycat. And the first thing I thought of was sea creatures, but not ordinary sea creatures. Ones with many eyes and many faces and many noses, many limbs. Scary, but friendly. They had smiles. And all of a sudden, bolts of electricity would shoot through their body, up into the air, and they would connect with the ones floating across the top.
The first time I saw Bill Doodle, I thought, my God, he has enthusiasm. I'm Batman and he's Robin. I'm happy to have the support that he can see me as a genius.
She took away my fear. I was being a safe doodler. I was worried about what people think. I just went into my little world of, you know, safe little diagrams of just pictures of people and animals and things. I wouldn't explore the untapped creative side of myself. April took me there. I've never been the same man since.